Community by Harry Venning and David Ramsden. Episode 1, The Prisoner.
In your own time, Mr. Chisholm. It's no hurry. It's no pressure. You just tell me what's on your mind when you're ready to tell me.
I just told you.
Did you? Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Would you mind telling me again?
Well, I'm what's known in the gay community as a bear. That's to say, a large, hirsute, homosexual man. And sometimes I feel elated about my body shape. But other times the pressure to conform to a more acceptable gay physical stereotype makes me really depressed. Do you know what I'm saying?
I think so. You're a bipolar bear. Oh, thanks for the lift home, Helen. Do you want another cup of tea?
Oh, go on, Claire. Twist my arm. So how are things between you and Brian since
he slept with Gnarly's sister? It's okay to say it, Helen.
Well, yes.
Yeah, well, you know, they were pretty rocky quite a long time. But recently, Brian and I, we've been going to see a brilliant couples counsellor and things, they really have improved.
How?
Well, the counsellor acknowledged that although I had a right to be angry, my anger, interestingly, was preventing any chance of communication between me and Brian. So she suggested that Brian and I limit any discussions of his adultery to just 1 hour a day between 7 and 8pm.
And at any other time, the subject is off-limits?
Yes, yes, sir, that's right.
Well, how very civilised.
Do you know it is?
I'm really proud of you, Claire.
Thank you, Helen.
Evening, Helen.
Hello, Brian.
Hello, Claire.
Don't you hello Claire me, you filthy degenerate. Just you wait till 7pm, lover boy. I'm going to give you an hour of pure hell for what you did.
I can't find my mobile phone.
Is this it?
7pm, scumbag. Do you hear me?
Yes, that's it. Thank you, Helen.
I'm counting down the minutes until 7, you seedy little man!
Bye, Helen.
Bye, Brian.
Bye, Claire.
7pm! Payback time! You two-faced, cheating, odious piece of crap! It just seems to work. Good morning, Gnarly.
Good morning, Claire.
Oh, you're in a good mood this morning, Gnarly.
Oh, yes. I wake up to the sound of Chris Moyle's radio show. I do not know what Chris Moyle looks like, but from his voice, I imagine he must be a very sexy man.
Morning, everyone.
Good morning, Brian.
Good morning, Brian. Oh, by the way, Brian, I may work extra hours tonight. I might not get back until later.
About what time?
7:30. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
So just you wait till 7:30. Hello, Claire Barker.
Say by the bell.
What? No, 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 no. How many times? The answer is no, 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 no.
Who was that, Claire?
Market research. They were just asking me if I used moisturiser, and I told them that no, I did not.
Uh-huh. Maybe you should. I'll get it.
I'll get it!
Just let us at least talk to her.
Push off.
And who was that?
The milkman, lady, person.
So it is not one of the many parents desperate to employ me because I am the very best nanny in the neighbourhood and everybody knows it.
No.
And you pay peanuts for wages and they offer to treble it.
Look, Gnarly, if you are not happy working for us as Thomas's nanny, well, you're more than welcome to leave.
Claire, we'd be helpless without her.
She's bluffing, Brian.
You know, Claire, maybe I will leave.
However, I should point out that not every British household is as sympathetic to the plight of the economic migrant as we are, especially those without the correct papers.
I have no papers.
We guessed as much.
I have a British passport. Did I not mention it? When I arrived in this country, I married an Englishman. It was a financial arrangement. I never thought I would see him again. 2 months later, he shows up on my doorstep. He needs more money. I give it to him. A week after that, he returns. He says it was not enough. It was then I realized drastic action must be taken.
What did you do?
I killed him.
Oh, well, Gnarly, I'll tell you something.
I hurt him.
What?
Look at our faces.
No, not this time. But since then, I am a respectably married English woman. Have you never wondered why my name was Gnarly Ramsbottom?
We do appreciate you, Gnarly, and we are more than prepared to show it.
Bearing in mind that we are in the middle of a terrible economic depression.
No need, I want for nothing.
You see, well, I'm glad to hear that. Okay, well, I'm off to work.
Except?
Except what?
I want to invite my friends round.
Well, that's fine. It's not a problem.
Only, well, I may have told them some small fibs that you would have to go along with.
Such as?
This is my house.
Well, you know, okay.
Thomas is my child.
Right.
I have an au pair. That's you, Claire. So you will have to serve us all evening.
Okay, well, just this once.
I suppose you want me to impersonate your husband?
Don't be ridiculous.
How dare you, Fisher? How dare you say that to me? Take your offensive mouth to the headmaster immediately and you say to him exactly what you said to me.
But, sir...
And tell him I recommend immediate exclusion. Now, go.
A bit harsh, wasn't it, Simon?
No, Brian, it wasn't. David Tennant was the best Doctor Who bar none. And I will not hear otherwise.
A bit tetchy today, aren't you, Simon?
Oh, maybe. I had a terrible time yesterday evening.
Why, what happened?
Well, you know, I've been having relations with Jacqueline and Pauline and Manuela and Yvonne and Beth.
Yeah?
Well, last night they all came to see me at the same time.
Wow, that's some coincidence.
Not really, it was parents' evening.
Simon, what have I told you before about sleeping with the parents?
Brian, I wish I'd listened. They weren't happy when they realised the situation.
What did you do?
What I always do, I promise to bump their kids' marks up.
It isn't right that you inhabit a world entirely composed of guilt-free sex and breathing, whilst I commit one teensy-eensy-weensy act of infidelity and I suffer eternal torment.
No, Brian, it isn't right, especially since you didn't even sleep with the girl you thought you were sleeping with. Remind me again, Brian, how did that happen?
Well, I think we covered a lot of ground there, Dexter, so I'll see you tomorrow.
No, I can't make tomorrow. I'm doing community service.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got caught up in the riots. The police arrested me, looting the spiritual awareness bookshop.
What were you doing in that?
Well, I'd already looted all the sportswear, electrical gear and consumer goods I could carry. But when I got it home, I still felt strangely empty.
Horror, where the hell is Claire? She knows it's a team meeting.
I'm sure she'll be along soon.
Ooh, nice trainers, Helen.
Yeah, thanks, Ray. I got them from one of Claire's clients. They're not pristine, I know, but for a fiver, I say, who cares about a bit of smoke damage?
Hi, everyone. Hi, sorry I'm late. Hi.
All right, everybody, I declare this team meeting open! Okay, first, I've spotted a culture of blame developing in this office, and when I find out who's responsible, I'm gonna bloody kill him. Second, the ashes. It was 6 months ago, shut up. Third, the police have suggested introducing a distress code for social workers on home visits. Now, if for any reason you feel uncomfortable or at risk, you call the office and ask to speak to Sheila O'Sullivan. SOS. Yeah? SOS.
Okay.
Got it? Clever, huh?
Yeah.
Finally, I bought a load of tea and biscuits just in case the big society kicks in and we find ourselves with a bit of time on our hands. Helen, you want to say something?
Point for the record.
Yep, go ahead.
I should like to see David Cameron fall over a cliff and have his face ripped off by a gorse bush. And I'm sure I speak for everyone in the caring professions.
Okay, duly noted. Ray?
Thank you, Libby. Now, I have a home visit with the Bartons this afternoon and...
The Bartons? Rather you than me.
Hey, Helen, support it.
Oh, you'll be fine, Ray.
Megan? Megan, are you paying attention?
Oh, sorry, Libby, I'm a bit distracted. It's my wee Brenda's behaviour at her new school.
Getting worse?
No, it's getting better, which means I've got no reason to go and see the handsome headmaster anymore.
I thought Brenda was at the Steiner school.
No, they expelled her.
I thought expulsion was against the Steiner philosophy.
OK, they didn't expel her. They relocated the school without telling us. It amounts to the same thing.
Thank you, Megan, if you don't mind. Finally. Claire.
Yes?
Go home.
What?
You're not doing your job properly, and you haven't for a while.
I don't know what you mean. There's been absolutely no perceptible increase in the number of complaints against me.
Claire, you've let your personal life distract from your professional.
It's rubbish.
Claire, I hope you don't mind, but I took a look at the notes you made during your interview with Mr. Chisholm.
Yeah, well, I made extensive notes. So what?
Yeah, 15 pages.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.